Well, hey everyone, it is MP5 Monday. It's Monday night, December 4th, 2023. Unbelievable, this year has flown by. This week, kind of going to be interesting. My daughter's got a big interview and her boyfriend's got a big interview that I helped set up for him. So hopefully he doesn't fumble the ball there in the end zone, and hopefully she crushes it, and maybe tonight we'll have a little party guest number 10 and a little red wine and wish them luck here after we get this video done. Tonight, MP5 Monday, this is for Thomas in Fort Lauderdale. He said, hey, can you talk about the history of the MP5 SD? And while the history of the MP5 SD, I don't know how exciting it is. Let's just talk about it a little bit. MP5 SD right here, or the Schalldämpfer, silencer, quiet, hush, puppy, the quiet MP5, we'll call it. Well, this bad boy was introduced in the early 70s, about 1971. 1971, this bad boy came out, and the whole idea was, how do you make a platform better than attaching a suppressor that at the time with suppressor technology, et cetera, with the thread on and this and that, kind of made for this big long package that, you know, if you put that big long suppressor and you screw it on, it's not quite as compact and tight as something like this that they designed. So it was a way to make it, quote unquote, better. And the idea was, well, we're going to standardize, we're going to make it to where I could throw my buddy a magazine of 124 grain NATO spec ammunition, and he could put that magazine in his MP5 SD, and now we're going to turn that supersonic ammunition into subsonic ammunition. And how we're going to do it is with a shorter barrel, taking the standard 8.9 inch MP5 barrel down to just under 6 inches at 5 3/4, and putting 30 holes here to bleed gas off, and then let the gas bleed into a chamber before sending the round out. And we're going to take a supersonic round, and we're going to turn it subsonic by bleeding the gas off into a two-chamber suppressor. So at the time, this was big-time technology, which is really cool. I mean, that's probably, you know, as a kid growing up, loving HK, I just love the engineering, the ingenuity, and this kind of stuff, because here it's like, okay, we're going to take the MP5 platform and we're going to take supersonic rounds, and we're going to engineer a way to make those rounds subsonic so that ammunition standardized, and, you know, poof, now we got multiple options within that platform. So really, really cool. So the rounds are turned subsonic by, A, you've got the shorter barrel, and then you've got the ports to bleed the gas off into the two-chamber suppressor, and poof, you're off to the races. There are 30 holes in that barrel, by the way, which is kind of a potpourri of interesting knowledge to know about, and a two-chamber suppressor, aluminum, yada yada. So share mags with your buddy, take that 124 NATO, turn it subsonic, off to the races. The downside is, in today's world, you basically take that 9mm round and you turn it into the ballistics of a 380. Now, when you take a look at the fentanyl problem that we have, amongst other things, some of these doped up, yada yada, if you're in the elite forces that still use this platform, was the French GIGN, the German GSG9, the British SAS, the US Navy SEALs, and SWAT teams, I mean, you can run into some armored up and doped up dudes that something with the ballistics of a 380 might not be your first choice. So at the time, this was really, really cool. But again, its role has been kind of minimalized because of some of the enhanced threats that are faced today by elite units. The MP5 SD is still used today, still in use by several elite units. Even here, you know, SWAT teams, a lot of the SWAT departments will sell their SDs because they can make so much money just selling the parts kits and buy other stuff. And a lot of times, I've got a good buddy in North Carolina, their SWAT department uses these to shoot out streetlights when they're getting ready to go in and go down on a mission. So that's pretty cool. But anyway, that's kind of a brief history there for Thomas and Fort Lauderdale of the MP5SD history slash some facts of the MP5SD. As a side note, it's very easy to convert your HK MP5, your SP5 that you can buy right now as a pistol, and you can send it to some different builders and build your own MP5SD. Super, super easy. Maybe that's a topic for a later date. But if you ever wanted an MP5SD, it's never been easier to get one. All right, MP5 Monday. Hope you enjoyed a little bit of MP5SD talk and look forward to talking to you YouTubers soon. Later.